Okay, I've got to speak up because we're in traffic down here. I wanted you guys to get a glimpse of where we live. This is one block. Show them. This is one block from our home, our apartment, and it is Koreatown. And if you look closely, you can see a lot of Korean writing and things. And this is why I said it on my other channel, but not on this one. Oh, here, look at that sign. But this is why we are going to try to learn Korean, because a lot of our neighbors, well, we're in our building, pretty much everyone knows English, but a lot of our neighbors do not know any English. And so, I mean, neighbors in the neighborhood. And so we're gonna try to attempt it. And if I could use, we could use all the help that you guys could give us. And eventually maybe we will speak. And I think I learned my first word the other day.
Oh, really? What was it?
Yeah, bashta. I think it's bashta means delicious. I think, I'm gonna recheck it today. We're gonna go and do a mini mukbang at the city center of Koreatown, which we just live, it's right over there. Right, show them. It's just a couple of blocks from our home. And it is the mall, the Korean mall. And so it's amazing. But the other day we had some wonderful food there. And so we're gonna go back and include you guys. Okay, see you guys later. Bye.
This is my dinner tonight.
Yeah, we're gonna do.
Mary's gonna do some more stuff afterwards.
We've come back to the Korean food court at the Korean Mall in our neighborhood. It's like 5 minutes away from where we live. It's amazing, and I think you can hear me better now. And so, I came here before and I ate this very plate and it was so good, but it was so, I had already food in my stomach and so I could not finish it. This time I am going to try to eat the whole thing and but except the soup, whenever I have soup, it turns out that, or whenever I have too much sauce, I gain weight because it never fails because of sodium. So I'm only gonna have a little bit of that, but other than that, I'm gonna try to eat everything. And oh my goodness, was it delicious last time? So this is, it was buckwheat noodles with, and I'm gonna use chopsticks. I'm gonna try not to make a fool of myself. And you gotta film me too, Jose. And it's got here buckwheat noodles with seaweed on the top. And this, I think, is cabbage. I'm not sure what kind of vegetable that is. This is just lettuce. Oh, here's cabbage too. Onions, chicken, cucumber, carrots, but they do it so pretty, right? And then eggs. And then, of course, every time you eat Korean, you have kimchi, and they always have these wonderful sides. And whatever Korean restaurant you go to. And this is kimchi. I don't know what this is, but it's just a side. I'll tell you when I eat it. And I don't know what vegetable this is. So I am gonna just have a little taste of this soup. Although I would love to eat the whole thing, but as I said, the sodium. So, very good. Too bad I can't eat the whole thing. Let me see the sauce. So good. At the end, I might put a little bit on it. Okay, so I've seen in mukbangs, and this is not a real mukbang, this is a mini mukbang, because I see that you eat a lot of food, and I was always envious of the mukbangs where they eat tons of noodles. And so I'm going to do it now. Let's see how I do with my chopsticks. Oh my. Okay, let's see. Oh, are you salivating out there? Let's see. I guess you wind it around. Very good. very good. I guess you're supposed to mix the whole thing. But I might not. I might just eat little bits here and there. But it is just so, and I, you know what? I am going to splurge and put a little bit of sauce on. Make everything a little bit Korean. And so, oh my goodness, very delicious. I just won't eat the whole thing. Okay, so this is a vegetable. I can't identify the vegetable, but the sauce is so good. It's just like a vegetable that you put in salads, but I can't identify it.
That one was very good. Oh no, it was delicious. I had it before you did. It's very good. I don't know if it's a potato.
It's like a potato.
It's like a seasoned potato.
Very good. And then, of course, this is kimchi.
Should ask him. Mm-hmm. Our friend Gina knows much about kimchi. Back in
Hi, Gina.
Back in Niagara, New York, she knows a lot about kimchi.
Here, let me get a big bite. Oh, my.
Mm. Is it good?
Very good. So good.
Look at that. Mm. And healthy looking.
Mm-hmm. That's why I chose this one.
It doesn't look like it's got a lot of calories to it.
That's why I chose this one, because
it's mostly vegetables.
It's hard to do mukbangs because I don't want to gain back my 70 pounds that I lost over 5 years ago. So, let me go for this.
Mm. Ready? Wow.
Very, very delicious. So we're gonna be out and about. Mm. I'm going to take you guys.
I'm going to get a haircut.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we found a Korean lady named Olive. She's got a very, very, very small little store. But we want to make friends in our neighborhood. And so we've got an appointment with her at 5 for Jose to have a haircut. Oh. I have to correct myself. I re-asked how to say delicious, and it's not bashta, it's mashta, I think. Didn't they say mashta?
Something like that.
And I can't wait to learn all my Korean words.
Yeah. We got some books. We downloaded three Korean books to study. They're each about 500 pages long.
Oh my. But Jose always, when we lived in Kenya, I worked so hard trying to learn Swahili. And hold on, gotta take a bite. I studied it for so long before we went, and then after we got there, every day I would study Swahili. And I only got to understand a little bit, but then Jose goes out on the street without even trying.
Because I had all, you know, I had basically all the words such as money, bathroom, food, yes, no.
But Jose
was able to. It was a slang Swahili.
Yeah, he was able to hold conversations.
Yeah, by just speaking slang Swahili. You know, where's the bathroom? Where's the food?
Cho.
Thank you.
Right? Cho is bathroom.
Cho, no, toilet. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Please. Money. You know, that kind of stuff.
I forget.
Slang money.
I forget how to say money. I forget.
Pesa.
Pesa. Oh, yeah, that's like Spanish.
Hakuna pesa. Mm. I don't have any money. Hakuna pesa. Mm.
So, I told Jose that he has to go at my speed, because, and I want him to help me, because he is a gift. I just choked. He is a gift of learning languages, and I obviously don't. It took me I started learning Spanish in 1983, and it's only now that I feel comfortable and kind of almost fluent in Spanish, but I still make a ton of mistakes.
Are you getting full?
No.
All the comedians are probably laughing at me.
You know what? They are such nice people.
Oh, I know.
Korean people are very, very, very sweet. Very
respectful.
I met
with my chopsticks, so I can hardly hold them.
Very respectful people, you know, friendly.
Wonderful.
Very,
so nice.
Very, you know, always, you know, dressed nicely.
Oh, yeah.
Very cultural, very hip.
And when we, you know what? It's funny. When we lived in New Mexico, that prepared us for, it's a lot like when we found out Kenya.
Yeah.
And then for a long time, we kept going to New York, and we had a lot of friends who were from New Jersey and were Korean, and we got to know some of the Korean culture.
Yep.
And so now that prepared us for here. Little did we know, because we flopped down. We did not intentionally move to Koreatown. What happened was, we were just trying to find an apartment that we could afford, that was nice and nice looking, that would take our two dogs, and that had parking, because it's very hard to find parking in LA. And that apartment really did it. And it just happened to be in Koreatown. And so, but little do we know that when we were in New Jersey, we were getting prepared. We learned a lot.
That's right.
One of the things that we learned when we were in New Jersey that was very, it was so neat. We really liked it, but it was very unusual for us, was that usually they have scissors on the table when they're going to eat meat.
No.
And they just pick up with a chopstick their meat, and then they cut it with scissors. One day we'll take you guys to a Korean barbecue, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I'm going to really look for a Japanese restaurant where I can find takoyaki.
What does takoyaki mean?
Octopus?
Octopus.
Fried in batter.
I don't know. We don't want that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Well, octopus is not all that bad. Octopus is... It tastes like squid. And
I'm going extreme. I want to go extreme.
And, you know, squid is not all that bad. Squid's okay.
So Jose, what do you have to say?
I'm just filming you today. I'm the gopher. I'm the video gopher. I'm here filming you, and then I'm gonna go out for my haircut, and we're hoping to meet new friends here, you know? It takes a while because you're just kind of landing here. Not knowing anybody, and then, you know, and then Los Angeles is a very busy city, so people are not just stopping all the time to get to meet you. It's, you know, you gotta get into it.
Let me know if I've got food in my teeth.
Let me see.
Yeah, I do.
Let me see.
Do
I? No? Good that you're fine. And then our daughter, Sarah, is coming over Tuesday. And we're so excited, and we're gonna take her too. There's so many neat things in Los Angeles. There's Koreatown, Griffith Observatory, which is, you know, where you can see these Los Angeles from thousands of feet high at nighttime. There's observations of stars and planets. There's a Seal Beach close to San Diego, where there's tons, 30, 40, hundreds, a couple hundred seals on the beach just laying there. We're gonna go hiking.
You gotta take them with us, right?
There's a Hollywood sign. Hey, that'd be like a neat. That's a neat video. Just so
I did that on my other channel, but we can do it again.
No. You never shot the Hollywood
sign
video.
I sure did.
No.
when we were, when we came to visit Bowie, Lexi.
I don't remember you shooting just a video. Mm-hmm. But that is like a 13-mile hike, or like a 10-mile hike. And you probably burn, no, I think it's a 9-mile hike.
I also filmed Seal Beach, but and, this time it will be with and Sarah you and Bowie and Lexi.
Burn about 900 calories on that hike. And then we're going to go to Hollywood. We're going to go to, where else? We're going to go on the subway. We're going to go, I don't know, there's so many things. We're going to go to family, friends. What else is there to do here? There's, you know, so many things. I mean, right? Just, you know, there's the, Beverly Hill Mansions. There's the Walk of the Stars. There's West Hollywood.
And
there's
the other day we made a new friend. We were walking our dogs and she wanted to take us to learn the subways.
So we actually did just a city walk on the Universal Studio. We didn't actually go inside because it costs a lot of money and we did not have money to really spend, but there is a walk that the subway leaves you there, and then you just walk around and you don't have to pay any money. But they have all these restaurants, and we did eat crepes.
Mm-hmm.
And we had there was a crepe place. I had one was what we had a Nutella crepe with like a vanilla ice cream, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we had a, what's the other crepe that I had? Oh, I had a Giraldi chocolate crepe with ice cream. And then what happens is, even though it's a lot of calories, you end up walking so much because parking is very bad, so we always try to walk. So we end up, like in New York, we end up walking a lot.
We love it, and now we're...
So here, you get the benefit of being able to eat just like this,
mm-hmm.
and then afterwards walk. And by the time that you finish walking, you have burned off all your calories.
And we have to, we're only two or three blocks from the subway.
Yeah, and we're learning, and that subway can take you virtually to Pasadena, Santa Monica, right?
Mm-hmm.
Santa Monica Pier, takes you, I mean, it's really amazing.
And we're gonna take them over.
So LA is an amazing place, a lot of nice people. Weather is great, like today the high is 69 and the low will be 53. And every single day at nighttime it gets into the 50s.
I'm getting very full.
Well, anyways, I got the haircut in about half an hour or so.
Mm.
But you've eaten a lot. But you know what? It doesn't have a lot of calories.
Mm.
When you're eating, it's like basically vegetables.
The noodles.
Yeah, but then after it's like you're gonna walk it off.
I'd like you guys to please let me know some Korean the things that we shouldn't do.
If you have any Korean friends, that can give us
advice on what not to do.
Words, special words.
Mm-hmm.
Gestures, readings, blah, 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 mm-hmm. that kind of stuff. That'd be great. I know that our friend Gina, back in New York, she'll probably give us some, probably give us some tips on that.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's Pastor David Kim, but Pastor David Kim back in Niagara doesn't always watch her channel, I don't think. So, yeah, this has been fun.
Mm-hmm.
What do you call this kind of a video?
Mukbang.
Mukbang? Why do you call it a mukbang? It almost sounds like mud.
No.
Mud. Muck.
No, muck.
Or like muck is like mucky.
We used to have a Siberian Husky when I was growing up named Mukbang.
Okay.
And because that means, I think, big shoe in Eskimo. Maybe I'm wrong.
Okay. Well, anyways, this is a, Koreatown is one of the, it's a really hip place. A lot of restaurants. people are always like, you know, dressed up, you know. A lot of culture, nightlife, a lot of people eating out, restaurants, a lot of young people, such as us. You know, really. Hey, youth is a matter of the heart.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen old people, which are very young, and I've seen young people who are very old. It's a matter of the heart.
Mm-hmm.
Like my stepfather, like my stepfather who died, I mean, he was about close to 90, and he had one of the youngest hearts. Remember that?
Mm-hmm. Manolo.
He was 90, but the guy was so cool. And he had the heart like of a 25-year-old kid, right? And I am not endorsing this. I'm not encouraging this, but Manolo was the worst eater. He ate the most unhealthy foods in the whole world, right? Fried food, tons of chocolates, spaghetti, fried food, fried chicken. And he almost lived to be 90, and he worked almost until the end of his life. Super energetic, super healthy guy. Went out to parties, dancing, with a heart like of a 25-year-old kid, and yet he ate garbage. Of course, I'm not endorsing that.
No, but
I'm not endorsing it. I think that there is a correlation in between healthy food and like health, and bad food and sickness. But here's an example of a guy that ate the worst foods, the worst.
I got some sauce.
Okay. He ate the worst foods in the whole world, right? And yeah, he lived until 90. He had his own business, worked until almost the day he died.
This was so good, but I just can't.
No, it's enough. Anyways, I got my hair cut.
I just can't. It was so good. I've never really watched
This is fun. I think it's good.
Mukbang to see if they eat the whole thing. But
hey, I really like this.
This is a mini mukbang.
I would like to do that one for my channel.
Oh.
Like when I'm talking about the Bible and then after it's eating. Right?
Yeah. Okay, guys. I guess we'll go. Wonderful being with you.
Bye, guys.